This is going to be the second video about square roots and radicals. So in the first video, we learned that if we have something like this, which is read as the square root of 9, we're looking for the number that we can square to get this 9. In other words, the number underneath the radical sign. And that's going to be a 3. Now, we can also have something that looks like this. You notice I've still got this radical sign. I've got a number under the radical sign, and I've got this little number 3 over here. Okay, well, this number 3 is called an index. And by the way, the number under the radical sign is called the radicand. I'll write it for this. But typically people just say the number under the radical sign. Okay, what this says is we're looking for a number that we can raise to the 3rd power and cube to get an 8. In other words, because we have a 3 here, we're not looking for a number we can square, we're looking for a number that we can raise to the 3rd power to get an 8. Okay, so thinking through what could we multiply by itself, in other words, something times something times something to get an 8, well, the answer would be a 2, because 2 times 2 times 2 equals 8, or we could just say 2 to the 3rd power is 8. So the answer to this is 2. Okay? Now, let's look at another one. Here we have the 3rd root of negative 8. Now, you remember in the previous video, we said that if you had something like the square root of negative 9, you couldn't do anything with it. There was no solution. But 3rd roots, in fact, any root that's an odd number, like a 5th root or a 7th root, you can find the root of a negative number, the 3rd root of a negative number. Now, here's why. Is there a number that we can raise to the 3rd power to get a negative 8? Okay, well, yes, there is. That number is negative 2, because negative 2 to the 3rd power, well, that's negative 2, I use parentheses, negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4, and positive 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. So when you see a negative sign, but the index is 3, then you're going to have a negative answer, which is perfectly okay, and it's going to be the 3rd root of whatever you have under the radicand, or the number that you can cube to get to the radicand. Okay? So let's look at some problems that use this. Okay, here we have 7 times the 3rd root of 125. This is sometimes read as the 7 times the cube root of 125. Okay. Well, before we can multiply anything by the 7, we've got to deal with this radical sign. So we're looking for a number that we can cube to get 125. And since it ends in a 5, and numbers that end in 5 usually have 5 as a factor. In fact, they always have 5 as a factor. We should probably try 5. And 5 times 5 times 5 is 125. So in other words, the 3rd root of 125 is 5. So now we can write 7 times the equivalent of this radical 3, 125. In other words, the 3rd root of 125, and that's 5. 7 times 5 is 35. So that's going to be my answer. Here's one with a negative sign, a negative number under the radical sign, but there's no problem with that. So we want the 3rd root of negative 27. Okay, well, the number we're looking for, the number, in other words, the number that we can cube to make a negative 27, first of all, is going to be a negative number. And if you think through some of the possibilities, you're going to end up with a negative 9, a negative 3, I'm sorry. So we get negative 3. That's going to be what the numerator of this fraction is equal to, divided by 6. And now we'll simplify our fraction. So we're going to divide the numerator and the denominator by 3. And we'll get a negative 1/2. Okay, here's another one. I've got 3 plus the cube root of 64, everything divided by 3. I want to start with the cube root. Well, the cube root of 64 is 4. 4 times 4 times 4 is 64. So I'll rewrite this as 3 plus 4 divided by 3. And of course, I have to add these together. So 3 plus 4 is 7 over 3. I can't simplify this anymore, so I'll just leave it like that. Okay? So here's some advice. You should make for yourself a chart, perhaps one that looks like this, that lists all the numbers from 1, I would say, down to 12. And then write the square of each of those numbers. In other words, 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, all the way down to 12 squared is 144. Make another column, and you should write the cubes of each of these numbers going as far as 6. In other words, you should know by heart, because it will make everything a lot easier on a test. You should know by heart that 2 cubed is 8, and 3 cubed is 27, 4 cubed is 64, 5 cubed is 125, and 6 cubed is 216. And just for safety's sake, you might want to do fourth powers also, at least to the fact that 2 to the fourth power is 16, and 3 to the fourth power is 81. Okay, so just take a few minutes on your own, make a chart like this, and memorize all those various powers. Okay, we have time for a few more problems. So here we go. I've got the fourth root of 16. Okay, let's go back to the chart. So I'm looking for fourth roots. I've got a 16 here. The fourth root of 16 would be 2, since 2 to the fourth is 16. So this is going to be, oops, I ruined my 4. This is going to be a 2. Now, because this index is even, just as we saw when we had square roots, anytime there's an even index, we're looking for the positive number that we can raise to the power of that index, in other words, 2 to the fourth, to get the radicand. Even though negative 2 to the fourth is also 16, if this is an even number, we want a positive number as our solution. Here's another one. I've got the fourth root of 81. Okay, so after you memorize your chart and everything, you'll very quickly know that the fourth root of 81 is 3. If we had wanted a negative 3, if we wanted to get something that would produce a negative 3, we would have to put a negative sign in front here, and then we would take the fourth root of 81, which would be 3, and we would negate it and make a negative 3. Okay, so that's it as far as these are concerned. The next video will deal with roots of variables, but make sure you take some time and really memorize your squares, your cubes, and fourth powers. Okay, you'll really find it comes in handy. See you soon.